Well, boys and girls, it's official. Mr. Fangio is officially coming to South Beach for the next year. What is up, Finn fans? So yes, we all heard the news today. I mean, for those of you who didn't know, Vic Fangio or someone announced, I think it was Barry Jackson that announced that Fangio was coming to Miami on, I believe, what was it, Sunday? And then it was like, oh no. They haven't agreed to terms as it said in the tweet. Fangio said, oh no, still undecided. I'm still focusing on, you know, my team, which is the Eagles, going to the Super Bowl, whatever. You know, that's understandable. So, which made a lot of Dolphin fans confused, even me, because I made a community post saying, welcoming and congratulating Fangio for coming to the Dolphins, as I did with a lot of the other fans. I saw the tweet saying, no, not confirmed yet. So, and originally I was going to make a video saying, like, will Fangio come? Will he not? Will he do this? And like, well, now we got the answer. Well, but I'll still answer the question. I'm gonna pretend it didn't happen yet. Will it happen yet? I think it will. I think it will happen. Like I said, that I think Fangio is more concerned about being in that mind, that, you know, that chess mode mind. He wants to think of the championship right there and now. Doesn't want to think about next year, as any of them do. They're in the now, basically. They want to think about, you know, hosting the Lombardi Trophy in the great city of Philadelphia, even though their fans are trash, let's be honest. Now that we got Fangio, I've heard a lot of good things about him. You know, like everywhere he goes as a coordinator, always a top 10, top 5 defense, every single year, or almost every single year, ranked from either top 10 or top 5 or top 3. And, you know, like, for example, I didn't even know this, but thanks to Dougley Durung, but I think when this time with the Bears, you know, it was a top defense. I mean, granted, mediocre team, but the defense would always gave other teams some battles, some runs for their money. And, you know, they had studs like Khalil Mack and so many more. And I remember hearing that he was on the 49ers with Kyle Shanahan and McDaniel as well, which explains, you know, why he's going to come to Miami, because I heard they had a good relationship, which should be pretty spectacular, considering, you know, our loser defensive coordinator who couldn't call a play to save his life in the time span that he was here, you know, all season. I mean, I will give Boyer some slack, because he did try to, you know, work with whatever he could. He did. There was, like, some games where Boyer did do some good with defense, and other games, like, nothing. And I get half the players were injured. You know, X wasn't himself. Byron was just, you know, cruising for a living or whatever. And our secondary couldn't really do anything. They were inexperienced. They were young bloods. They were undraftees. Not really. Well, there's one undrafted player, but you all know who that is. And yeah, it's been a wild ride for Boyer, but he can go back home to his boyfriend Belichick. I'm glad we did get Fangio, really. I mean, I think him and Mike, like, if McDaniel can do what he did this season and fix the offense and make it, you know, a top fast-paced offense, then I'm sure Fangio can, you know, discipline his guys on the defensive end and get it going and get it to, you know, this scary offense or the scary defense that, you know, has been talked about for many, 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 many years with the Dolphins, at least from the likes of Jason Taylor, from Zach Thomas to Sam Madison to Patrick Surtain to Tim Bowens, to the rest of the Dolphins that played here before. I mean, not saying that Fangio's been here, but knowing the defense that we've had for years, I think Fangio can fix that for the better. I mean, let's just hope it's good. I hope it's, and I hope there's better play calling too, and better discipline on the defense as well, and the offense as well. And McDaniel has a lot to work about. And hey, Tua's out of protocol, so that's a good sign as well. Good for him. I mean, glad. I mean, I will admit, I was a bit shady when I heard about that he was still in protocol. Because he came to the game against the Jets and supported his team. I mean, unless the doctors allowed him to go, but he was still in protocol, which totally makes sense. I mean, I get that they're, you know, looking out for him, making sure he's a complete 100% before he goes out there banging heads on the field again, and we have to go through that same ordeal again, which we don't want to. We don't want to relive another Cincinnati moment where he's like cross-fingered and they're laying down there. We don't want to see that image again. But, you know, hey, good for him. Let's see what he can do. And let's see if the Dolphins can get a superior backup quarterback. That's not freaking Teddy Stonebridges or whatever they call him. And a seventh rounder who's not ready for the game. Let's be honest. But I'm expecting a lot. After, you know, an impressive five-game win and then a mediocre, an underwhelming five-game losing streak. Let's hope it's for the better. Keep that consistency going. Well, there you go. That's it. That's all I have. Fins up, guys. Fin Nation, get ready for next season, because I feel like it's going to be much of a bigger blast. All right. I'll see you next year, guys.